If you are working in retail or if you want to be a part of retail industry, then you should know what are the different type of reports used in retail industry. So friends, welcome once again to my channel, and if you are new here, then please consider subscribing for more such updates. So today we will be discussing what are the different types of reports used in retail industry. So management information system is a very important in retail store operations, which help in decision making concerning the business. There are various kind of reports one needs to maintain in a retail for the smooth operations of the store. So in this video, we will be discussing some of the most important reports used in retail for the decision making process. The first report is Daily Store Sales Analysis Report. This report has all the sales data of the particular store. The day sales, week sales and month sales are part of this report. This is the most basic report, and every retail store will have the daily sales report. The report also contains the department and category wise sales, which specifies which department has done how much sales for a specific period of time. The second report is Store Manager Recap Report. This is the most detailed report, which contains all the operational parameters and KPIs of the store. Store Manager Recap Report is extracted daily, and it contains previous day sales, week sales, month sales and year till date sales. This report also has the KPIs, which include average bill value, unit per transaction, number of footfalls for the store, conversion rate, average selling price of the product, gross margin and all the department sales in detail. This report also mentions the inventory present in the store, what is the sell through rate, what is the inventory turnover, and it also has what are the top 5 and bottom 5 articles selling for all the departments. This report also contains all the commercial aspects of the store, such as total cash collected, card payments made through gift cards and loyalty payments. All these things are covered in detail in the Store Manager Recap Report. The third report is called as Sales KPI Report. This report has a detailed analysis of all the KPIs of the store, which are sales achievement, gross margin, net margin, conversion rate, average bill value, sales per square feet, customer complaint closure rate and net promoter scores. With the help of this report, one can analyze how well the store is performing. And also, one can analyze this report to make sure all the parameters are improved and the KPIs are taken care of. The fourth report is called as Zero Sales Report. So as the name suggests, Zero Sales Report contains all the articles which are not sold within a given period of time. This is an SKU-wise sales report that will show how many products made a zero sales within a given period of time. So what is the importance of Zero Sales Report? Is this report generated to never source the items again? No, absolutely not. This report is generated to check whether the zero sale article is displayed on the floor or not. Most of the time, the zero sale article will be kept in the store warehouse, and also it may be displayed on the floor wherein the customers cannot find it. Because of this, it might have not sold and it will be reflecting in the zero sales report. So the fifth report is called as Top 10 and Bottom 10 Article Sales Report. So this report contains the top 10 and bottom 10 articles which are sold during a specific period of time. This is the department and category wise sales report. This report will contain top 10 and bottom 10 selling articles from all the departments and the respective categories. So what is the importance of this report? This report will help in planning the inventory. One must make sure that we have sufficient stocks of top selling articles so that those will not be stockouts. Also, we must check whether we have sufficient stocks of bottom 10 articles. Sometimes due to stockouts, the article might be reflecting in the bottom 10. If we have sufficient stocks of the bottom 10 selling articles in the store, then we must think of maintaining the stock in the minimum quantity as it is not selling in the retail store. The sixth report is called as Sales by Category Report. This report will help us to understand how much sale a particular product category is contributing to the overall store sales. This report can be generated on the department level as well as the product category level. For example, you can generate reports of men's department as a whole, and also men's formal sales, men's trouser sales, t-shirt sales, denims and jacket sales, so on and so forth. Similarly, it can be done for the women's wear and kids wear category also. So the seventh report is called as Service Quality Audit Report. Service Quality Audit Report is also called as Mystery Audit Report, and it will tell the service level and the service standards of the given retail store. The mystery audit happens once in every month, and the auditor will judge the store on the following parameters, which are look and feel of the store, cleanliness of the store facade, digital LED signage is working or not in the store, what is the staff grooming and what are the approachability, the product availability in the store, display standards and exchange policy. All these parameters are evaluated by the mystery auditor. Now coming to the 8th kind of reports, which are inventory management reports. Inventory managements involve proper maintenance of stock, inwarding and outwarding as per the SOP and maintaining overall healthy inventory. To track this, we have some of the important inventory reports, which are inventory on hand report, sell-through report, low stock report, inventory performance report. So, in inventory on hand report, the report will give the details about your existing inventory in the store. This report will help us to understand what all inventory we are carrying in the store. So the next report is sell-through report. This report will help us in understanding the amount of inventory sold in a given period of time relative to the amount of inventory received within the same period of time. The next inventory report is called as low stock report. This report will help us in understanding the low stocks at the given point of time. With this report, we can analyze that which inventory needs to be reordered and which inventory has to be stopped sourcing based on the sales trending. So the last inventory report is called as inventory performance report. This report has a details like inventory turnover, item fill rate and inventory accuracy rate, which will help us in analyzing the inventory of the retail store. So the 9th report which the retail store maintains is employee sales report. Employee sales report will give the details of the sales which is done by each and every employee of the store. This sales will be recorded on the employee sales ID, and through this we can understand which employee has done how much sales. This report is very important because it will help us to evaluate the productivity of the sales associate. Here the employee sales can be taken according to the department and according to the category. So now coming to the 10th and final type of report, which is called as profit and loss report. This is one of the most important report of the retail store. P&L report will tell you how the business is doing, and also we can get to know the profit made by the retail store for the given period of time. P&L is a monthly and yearly report in retail. The components of P&L are sales, gross margin, net margin, marketing cost, supply chain cost, rent, staff cost, utility cost, security cost and housekeeping cost. All these parameters will help us in understanding what is the expense made by the store to carry out the store operations. This is called as operational expense, which are the expense made to run the store on day-to-day basis. So friends, these were some of the most important retail reports which are used in retail industry. And these reports may vary from one organization to the other organization. So friends, if you like this video, then please hit the like button and please subscribe to my channel for more such updates in the future. Thanks for watching and see you all soon in my next video.